Okay, hello again. Thank you for being here. Now we have Robert Partyka, and this is the Vice President of the Polish Linux User Group and also owner of the Bobson Company. And in his talk, The Power to Change, he will ask a question and hopefully answer the question if there's a market for open source. Thank you for being here.
Hi, everyone. Thank you that you join me here for this short talk. I will try not to get into the light, at least until I start to make a funny faces on the shadow. The talk is about what I call the power to change, and I want to convince you that it's possible, it's in your power to shape the world and shape the future, because as we all know, the best way to predict future is to create the future by yourself. And of course, the best way is to do this according to your own ideas and your own beliefs. Before I start to talk about this, I want to introduce a little myself, because you may wonder what this redhead guy, which is a little old, come here, talk to young people, and behave like he knows something. As everybody knows, young people know that the old people don't know anything at all about the world. So I begin in the times with the computers. In the primary school, it was fourth grade of the primary school, and it was time, who knows what the Amstrad is, or ZX Spectrum. Hi, we are from the same age. It was age of the dinosaurs in the computers. Then there was a big stone coming from the heaven, and the era of the modern computer become. In those days, I start to love computers. I start to learn programming. When I get to the university, I found my company, which is called, as my stage name, Bobson, which was my nickname for a long time on the demo scene, where I was making open source, not knowing that I'm making open source, because everybody knows that the roots of the open source are in the demo scene, where everybody shared the source without any license at all. What's the license? So I invent the company, which was invent. I found the company. It will be nice to invent the company. But no, it wasn't that. I found the company Bobson, and we start to create software. And we even start to create software and sell software exactly in the open source way, don't knowing that it's open source. It was about a year later when I start to get into the Linux and find out, okay, we're doing this exactly as the license say, so why not doing this more? And nowadays, we change the direction of the company. We are no longer the company about the software itself. We became a research company, which are more into the hardware also, but we based on the open hardware. And we funding solution for the people if they have ID, but they don't know how to do this, what they need in the software, what they need in the hardware. We're creating the documentation for them, the prototypes, and preparing the whole documentation for the production. And they get it also based on the approach from the open source and freedom it gets. So is there a market for open source? The shortest answer I can give you as an example from my 17 years of and what's happening now, it's I landed yesterday in Poland, coming back from Sweden, from the client. I sleep 4 hours, come here to make a lecture, and I was want to stay for whole three days, but I cannot because the projects which are open source in my company needs my attention and I need to go back. So short answer is definitely yes, there is a market, but it's not a unicorn. It's not something which is only happening good for you because it's open source, but about that a little later. So what's the market? Because everybody tell, okay, there is a market for open source, but what's the numbers? That's the information you can get from the Wikipedia. I use those one because once on the conference about the open source in the Microsoft, we have a little argue because they was having a little different data, and I ask about the source. And it appears, because some of the data are from the Gartner, that their source was also Gartner. So I ask, okay, if this is Gartner, can I see this report? No, you can't, because we pay for it, and the agreement don't allow us to show this data. Nice way to get data for presentation from the report, which I cannot show to you because it's a top secret report, but I present you the one number, one figure, which is from this report. That's why I decide to use only data which you can check by yourself. Linux share nowadays for this month is about 2.11 to 2.33 of desktops. Based on the calculation from the usage in the internet. And those two figures are different because there are two different organizations which was measured this. Embedded system, Android, Ubuntu, and so on, it's about 30%. And those data are already a little aged because this company didn't provide new data for it. So it can be even more now. You can find it on the Wikipedia page. The deeper in the wood, the better. Web servers, 36%, almost 37. Mindframe, it should be now about 50% because it is prediction from the 2008. And supercomputers, we even don't need to talk about supercomputers. They even sometimes don't know what Windows is. When we look at the technologies of other type of the processors, so not the processors about the PC, so not the Intel, not AMD, but other architecture like M56 or processors which are REM, it's also like almost nobody use the Windows because what for? If you go to the science facilities like Polish facility about the space agency. It's also, if you are not a user of Linux, how you want to work with us? That's a question you can get. If you are a student and you don't know Linux at all, you have problem to become an astronomicist. And also, how much Linux kernel will cost? That's also data from the Wikipedia. With the model of the Kokomo, they estimate that it will be 612 million. European Union make its own estimation. I think it's twice the price from the USA, something like that. If we count also the difference in the currency comparison, so. It's quite a lot of money. I think there are maybe two companies in the world now which can afford that spend such kind of money for the developed kernel, maybe three, if we don't count companies which don't do IT at all. I think everybody can name those companies. One have the amount of money in the bank which can cover whole USA debt. So they probably can do this, but I don't think so. Other IT companies can afford such amount of money. So that's the potential which is in the open source world. We don't talk any longer about a bunch of guys which are hippies and they want to develop software, but normally they sell carrots because they need to make money for living. They're making software because they want to, and they want to make money on it. As I told in the abstract, which you can read probably on the web page of the QTCon, I told that I will tell you a little about rules to follow and rules to break. Rules to follow is a little more because unfortunately we live in the society, or fortunately we live in the society, which comes with the rules. So first one, I was really thinking which one should be first, and I tell that it's love, it's the first rule which you should follow. And there are two things. First thing, do what you love. If you doing what you love, you're never working. And you really like this, what you're doing. But secondly, you have families, probably you have girlfriends, never allow that you're working. It's my 17 years experience as an owner of the company. Never allow work cover all your life. Have family, have friends, go sometime out. It will make your work better. You will like to come back to work because I want to go out from this people. I want to do something. Holidays all the time are not good. So that's the first and probably primary rule which you follow. But then it's if you're really into being open, don't act only like being open, but doing something else. It's quite often that the developers say, okay, I like open source, I want to do open source, but I want to make money, so I need to do closed source. If you really believe that the open source is something good, and I, from my experience, can tell you that it's also a good business model, it will not solve all problems for you, because in every business model, you need to find the client, you need to find something he will want to buy. But follow the ideas you believe to into. Because on the other hand, it's something like, oh, I'm a Christian, but I'm not going to church, because why for? Really, are you Christian and you don't going to church? So are you really Christian? Or church or any other places where parts of the Christians go. So follow your ideas and think out of the box, because the problem of modern companies quite often is that they are so into how we already arrange something. They are like dinosaurs or scalpels from the stone. It's like we have our way of work. It's slow, it's ineffective, it's in fact not solving the problems, but we was doing this that way, and we are going to do this that way also for another 100 years until we die, and they probably die quite soon. So try to think about the finding solution. It's like you need to try to think, because usually people think that way, that, oh, I have problem, or my country have a problem, my city have a problem, my friend have a problem, girlfriend have a problem, child, dog, cat, and whatever else have a problem. Don't think about this as a problem. It's, for first, it's a challenge. For second, every problem society especially have is a potential for, it's opportunity for you. If you solve it, you probably can make a money on it. Because everybody should remember that in the rules of open source, in the four freedoms, then there is nothing about not getting money for it. It's even exactly told by the Stallman. It's not free beer. It's free as a freedom of speech. And it's even better if you do money on it, because if you do money on the open source, you prove that it's good concept for business model. And the more companies start to do this, the more people will believe in that. Because the problem of the small companies, for instance, is that they just don't believe in that. They don't, especially if they are not IT, they cannot judge the quality of the product. So how they judge the quality of the product? First, the size of the supplier. Secondly, the price. Usually people, if don't know how what's the quality, the highest price, the better. I want the computer. Which one? The best one. Which one is the best one? I think this with the highest price is the best one. That's how you sell computer as a hardware to the person which has no idea about the quality of the hardware, but won't have something best. If you give him something which is really best, but it is cheaper than the highest price in the shop, he will feel that he is not treated well by you. It's the way the people think. We cannot do anything about that. The usually best way to change the shape, the way your boss act, is to change the boss. Because you have the power to change the boss, for instance. Next thing, law. We live in the countries has law. You need to follow this law. We have the 78, I think, as I could remember, open source licenses which can be used, which are approved as open source licenses. But you need to know how to apply them to the law which is in your country, because quite often, the way of applying, so for instance, if it needs to be signed by two sides or not, is depending on the law in your country. Get good lawyer. Spend some money for the lawyer, because he will help you in many situations. Because, for instance, the lawyers of your contractor may want to shape the way of how you sign the license, how it will be written, that at the end it will be not open source license. I have now, in fact, such exchanging of the changes in the agreement, because the contractor on the other side is changing all the time the license, the whole agreement, that in fact the open license stopped becoming open license. Next thing is you need to pay taxes, but you don't need to pay the biggest possible taxes. So also get a lawyer, he will tell you what to do, and you need to do that. Probably. In maybe a few years, they will solve this problem, because it's opportunity to make a good money. Maybe they will do this open source also. Rules to break. I choose only two, because we don't have 1 hour for talk, and usually if I choose more, then we're talking for about 1.5 hours. So I choose only two. First one, the IPR, intellectual property right. What the hell is that? For first, how you can make a property of something which even don't exist. Because its property can be to this chair. If I have this chair, nobody else have this chair, even if there is a lot more chairs here. But what's the who tell me what's the most overused word by the people which are into IPR? Piracy. Yes, piracy. As I know, in the law, piracy, it's an act of encounter other ship in the sea, or in the, it can be also applied to the fly jet, but mainly it's about the ships. So I'm into fighting with the piracy. We can send all our warfare, which is on the sea, to fight the pirates in the Africa. No problem for that, but don't even start to talk with people which use this word in the way of intellectual property rights infringement, because it's not. This word has the meaning in the law, in the international law, and there is only one meaning for this word in the international law. You can find it also on the Wikipedia, what's the real meaning on the piracy. So, but you make a software, and okay, it's your software. So what to do with that? I don't stop making the problem from this that somebody gets your software. If you make it open source, it's okay, somebody has my software. It's even good, because it starts to become popular. The more, the better. You, in fact, break the main problem which the closed source companies have. They spend a lot of money for fighting people which copy their software. And those people sometimes copy this because they just don't have money to do anything. Find the other way to make money on this, what you're doing. And second, it's the old corporate approach to client. Old corporate approach to client is, of course, they behave like they want to kiss your ass when you want to buy something, and they totally forget about you when you already done this. And secondly, when you read agreement or license, for instance, from Microsoft, it's like, you should pray to us with thanks that we allow you to install this on only one computer and use this only by you, because if you give this software to your friend on your computer only to use, then you break the law. Quite often, I only win with the competitors, because I threat people. My approach to the client is exactly what the rules of open source say. It's your partner. It's not your enemy, which you quite often can read that. The famous sentence before you buy the DVD with the movie, as they called legally. And first thing which you see, you will not download the movies. I didn't download this, I just buy it. Why you show it to me? So don't approach that way to the client. Approach as he's your partner. Talk to him like a partner. And then they usually even don't use the rights for which becomes from the open source license. And they probably will come to you for the changes because you made the software or you made the software working for them, because quite often open source software, it's like for everything. So it's for, maybe not for nothing, but it's not really doing what the client wants to. So what you're selling is your work. What is work? It's energy in time. And this is what you should be paid off. If you don't working for somebody, why you should get the money? So, how to earn money? Because I'm talking that it's possible to earn money. As I told, we, for instance, searching solutions for the client. So we use open source components. We use open hardware. But client, which is not IT, corporation, or they are totally not into IT, or they even don't want to be IT. They want the solution. If it's open source, it's even better for them, so they will give you another points because you give them more possibilities to use the solution than the others with the closed hardware and closed source. But you're selling them knowledge. So in short, because we have only, I think, a few minutes left. 4 minutes, okay. In short, it's you need to find the... you don't selling the software, you're selling knowledge. You're selling approach to the client. Sometimes client wants something in the box, so you just putting the copy of Ubuntu with the T-shirt into the box, and you're selling this, and you're earning money. You, of course, don't selling license for the Ubuntu. You're selling the plastic of the CD, and the fiber of the T-shirt. But you're selling this, and people like to have box. The software is the best-selling air in the box. You're buying the game, and you have such box with the air inside, because there is only paper with the code for the download. So if you want to sell air, it's just make software boxes and put it in your shop. You can find, you can, for instance, use the donations for create software, which is probably needed on the market, but one company will not pay for it, but several will probably do. If you go to them and tell, okay, we're starting such project, we need such grant from you, this is what you will get from this. Find client which needs something which is not on the market, and nobody will, from the big companies, will do this for them, because sometimes big companies even, okay, we will do this for you. Five million grants. Why? Because we don't want to write it, but we will never tell you that we will not going to do this for you. We will just make a price such high that you will never pay for that. So there are places in the software designing and software creation where you can apply your rules and your ideas and make money on it. Because as I told, open source is for first not about giving to everybody. It's about giving to your client in the business model. You may do this, that you give this for everybody, but it's your choice. So you need to find the way, if it's good for you also to give it to everybody. If you have another approach like software as a service with your instant support, which will get you money from it, and then it's even better, give this to everybody, because everybody, if it's good software or if it's good hardware, everybody will attach new code to this. So you're gaining from the giving this to everybody else. But you need to always think about it. But the thing is that you can make a money on it, you can charge for it, you can tell, you need to pay for my work. And secondly, you are only giving this to your client. If this client will decide, okay, I'm going with this public because it's open source and I can do this according to the law, it's his choice. Quite often, he is not going to do this because the solution which is exactly for him, working only in his environment, in a way he has company organized, and everybody else do this differently, so nobody will even want this software. Samsung was complaining once on our conference in Poland that they published the code for the drivers for the TV screens, and there is a very small amount of people which even download this. It may happen. Making something open source don't mean that you become a famous, because if it's software about the screens, what to do? I was about to tell you last but not least, but if somebody wants to know about the approach of the in company which is needed to have, then we can do this off stage or in the question. And of course, if you want to contact with me, don't hesitate. Just write email, ask questions, tell that I told stupid things also. If you want to, I will not send something back in the pocket to your house because of that. So it's feel free. If you go to the webpage, don't be surprised. There is only the logo and the click for the contact, because we're changing webpage, and because of amount of open source project we have now, I didn't done the final check yet for the what the copywriters done. So that's all from me. Hope you feel that you have power to change, because you do. And if there are any questions, then please now.
Yeah, thank you very much, Robert. Let's do a 5 minutes question answers, if there are any. Any questions? Okay, just a moment.
Thank you, first pitch, once again. And I would like to know, you told that you do a lot of, let's say, consulting in order to help your clients to empower their infrastructure, workflow, whatever. So, can you share some insights on what part of your revenue comes from consulting compared to what comes from software development itself? Just an estimate.
You mean the amount of money comes from this?
Yes, just
nowadays, it's in fact half and half. So it's half from the software development, which is in fact not only software development, because we always make a consulting for the architecture and for the design. So it's not only write the code according to the specification, even if you know that it will never work. So because that's what quite often happened on the market, but we always consult the solution with the client. And second part of the income is from the research in the mostly hardware projects.
And okay, thank you. Do you believe consulting will stay around for quite a while?
When we want to do something new, so I was having friends which was great electronic guys, and I was always liking to also play with the electronic when I was young, so we decided, okay, we are going to be something like research facility also. And the next day, I pronounced this to my business partners that we are going to do this. We was having the first client for it. So I think it will stay, because we are, in fact, we have, as I told you, 50% of the income is from this. And I don't do any active selling work from now. So I think it can even overcome the software designing. Especially that you have a little more things possible to do when you are integrator, consultant, and so on, than only software designer. So you always need to design some software in it, because of course hardware now don't work without the software. But
okay, thanks. Thanks for being clear.
Any more questions in the audience? Oh, over there.
Does your company sell software to other companies, for example, or does it mostly produce software which is relevant for companies, or is it also software for like end users, people?
Mostly we do the software for the web applications nowadays and some software for the mobiles. In most cases is that we are subcontractor, or that there is a software company which wants to have something, or there is a company which creating a bigger solution and they need software which they cannot produce because they are not a company which making software. Sometimes, but it's rather minority, we do software for the companies which are totally not from the designing something for the others. They just want something for themselves. But we always provide this in the, there is, for fears, we always have strict rule in the agreement that the open source components are open source and are provided as open source. And secondly, we give SLA for our software, but it's additionally to the normal license of the software, which is one of the open source. Usually it's even not GPL, but rather the MIT or similar. We have 78 open source licenses to use, which are open source. So there is, you can choose a lot.
Thank you. Any more questions? Else, I would say thank you very much again.
Thank you.
Also to the ones
asking
questions.
It was nice to be here.